Hi everyone, and welcome to our webinar today on our PressLink closed loop solution. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Chelsea Conrad. I'll be your presenter today. I have Devin Abramowitz with me, our sales manager, who's going to be assisting with this presentation. Throughout the presentation, we encourage you guys to interact with us by typing in questions and comments using the question pane on the right hand of your screen. We're going to be answering all of your questions after the presentation during a question and answer session. We're just going to wait a couple minutes and give everyone some time to log on and get settled. All right, well, it looks like we're all here, so we're going to get started.
All right. Well. well, thank you all very much for taking the time to join us here today. As Chelsea mentioned, we're going to be doing a presentation on our closed-loop solution. But to start, I wanted to take a few minutes to just give you an overview on Teshcon as a company. I'm not sure how many of you are familiar with us or what we do. Teshcon has been around for a little over 30 years now out of Germany. It's a family-owned and operated company. It's actually now the second generation of the family is running the company. And we, you know, manufacture and sell an entire line of scanning spectrodensitometers, also handheld products, software, basically anything to do with color measurement. And just to give you a little bit of an overview of our product line, I figured I'd go through very quickly a few of the products that we offer. First is our SpectroDrive. As you see here in this nice video, SpectroDrive is an automated wireless scanner that will scan a color bar for you in a matter of seconds. We also have the SpectroJet, which is very similar to the SpectroDrive. The SpectroJet is tethered to a computer by a cord, and as you can see here in the video, it's run manually by the operator. This is our flagship product, the SpectroDENS, our handheld product right here. As you see on the screen in this video, we are simply scanning a color control strip. This device can be tethered to a computer by a cord or wirelessly, or you can display the results right on the screen. Lastly is our SpectroEdge, which is an inline device we've created for the flexo and gravure industry. This device straps directly to the press, and as you can see there, takes measurements inline at production speed. Now that we've gone through our product line and a little intro on Teshcon, we're going to get into what everyone came here today for, and that's our PressLink closed loop solution. I'm sure most of your customers are becoming more color critical as time passes. Because of this, our clients are looking for ways to meet these demands while also decreasing costs by shortening their make readies, cutting down on wasted paper, ink, and time. Basically, you know, we've seen this out there in the field, and we've come up with a solution that we think meets all of those needs. So that's why we're here today to tell you and to launch and talk about our PressLink presetting and closed-loop solution. There are three main components of the closed-loop solution. I'm just going to give you a brief overview of how it works. Basically, the three components are the digital ink preset software, the SpectroDrive scanner, and the closed-loop color control software. The way it works is a prepress would send a file that would hit our file converter. That file would then be converted into an ink presetting file. That information would be sent to the press. The ink keys would then be automatically set to optimal levels based on that prepress data. Then as the press is running, the operator can pull a sheet off as often as they like, scan it with the SpectroDrive scanning spectrodensitometer, and then based on the valued measures from the SpectroDrive, the ink keys are automatically adjusted again, and that can be done throughout the press run and will help maintain target density and specified color values. I'm now going to pass it over to Chelsea to talk about some of the benefits of a closed-loop system and to talk to you about ink presetting as well.
Great. Thanks, Devin. All right. Well, you guys, you might ask yourself, why would I need or want a closed-loop solution? Well, first of all, it's going to reduce your make-ready time by at least 30%. By reducing the amount of ink and paper used for make-ready, you're also substantially reducing how long make-ready takes, which translates to more productivity. Another key benefit is that presetting the ink keys reduces ink and paper waste by at least 50%. If you're using, on average, 400 sheets during typical make-ready, think of the savings that you're going to recognize in ink and paper by only using 200 sheets for make-ready. You're also going to see an increase in productivity. This system allows your customers to increase their productivity while decreasing their costs. The more time your customer has, the more potential work they can bring in-house. It could even help eliminate or shorten some shifts. A closed-loop solution will help you reduce the number of remakes by proactively correcting problems as they happen, not after they happen. As Devin mentioned earlier, there's three components that make up PressLink. The first component is digital ink presetting. The PressLink converter evaluates the SIP3 file from prepress to determine the optical ink coverage settings and generates an on-screen color proof for the press operator. The PressLink Digital Ink Presetting Software takes the optical ink coverage information from the converter and presets the ink fountains on the press, offering accurate density and color at the beginning of every press run. PressLink offers customers the tools required to meet the current day challenges of decreasing prices, increasing costs, and customers who demand higher color quality. I'm just going to hand it back to Devin, and he's going to dive into the other components in more detail.
Thanks, Chelsea. The second component is the closed-loop color automation. During production, the press operator will periodically measure press sheet color bars with the SpectroDrive, as you see right here on the video on the screen. The PressLink color control software displays the measured density, color, and G7 information for all colors and adjusts the ink fountains automatically, maintaining accurate color and density from start to finish. What I'm going to show you next is an actual screenshot of the software so you can see exactly what it looks like. Currently, we're in the closed-loop portion of the software, but as you can see here, there are other options you can control or just by density or just by G7. But for the purposes of this, we're just showing you it in the straight closed-loop view. As you see here on the right side of your screen, you're going to have your total averages, so your total delta E, your minimum delta E, your density, your target density, your 40 and 80% patches, and your slur as well. You may also notice that there is no information in keys 1 through 5 and keys 19 through 23. That's because those keys are grayed out. You do have the ability to gray out any ink keys that you'd like. You know, you may not be using those keys at all, and you wouldn't want any, you know, data from those keys, I guess, skewing the overall average numbers. And basically, this is just a representation. Whoops, as you can see here, it's just a representation of your ink keys. What is in black here are your actual targets that you're trying to hit, and the red display that you see is the measured data. As you take more scans and the press automatically adjusts itself through this software, you'll see as we scroll through here, your delta E is going to get closer, or your measured data is going to get closer and closer to that target value until it's actually right within any of the tolerances that you set. So that was it for the screenshots of the software. Chelsea is now going to talk to you guys about something that I think everyone cares a lot about, and that's money.
Thanks. Well, calculating the return on investment is easy. By calculating the current time for your make ready, numbers of jobs per day, cost of ink and paper, quality consumed, hourly press costs, working days per year, and the savings in time and materials, it clearly demonstrates the benefits of this system. On your screen, you're going to see a sample ROI that we have based on industry averages. We do have a calculator that we'd be happy to send along to any of you if you're interested, that you can plug in your own real numbers to determine your individual ROI. But since you'll be purchasing the system in year one, you're going to realize your full return on investment in 3 to 4 months. Based on the industry averages that you saw on the previous slide, your first year savings minus the cost of the system, it's approximately $133,830. The investment cost can vary based on the make, model, and year of the press and console. As mentioned earlier, the average annual savings after year one is $193,830. Most of our customers actually think this system is a no-brainer as it pays for itself.
Okay, and to kind of wind things up a little bit, I know throughout this presentation we've been, you know, showing you videos, and you've seen a couple different screenshots of our of the hardware that we sell that actually drives this system. So just to let you know, there are two pieces of hardware, the SpectroDrive and SpectroJet, that can both drive the system. The SpectroDrive is an automated scanner. It's wireless. It's not tethered to a PC at all. The SpectroJet, as you see right here, is, you know, pretty much the same as the SpectroDrive, except it's manual. The end user actually drive it themselves, and it has to be tethered to a PC via a port. Both of the devices, though, can scan a 40-inch color bar in 8 seconds and can measure the color bar anywhere on the page. Lastly, we wanted to talk a little bit about configurations and kind of, you know, how we deal with installing these systems. As all of you know, there's really no two presses in the world that are exactly the same, you know, especially when considering all the different, you know, makes, manufacturers, models, and years that these presses have come out. We have installed several systems already, and we can interface with most presses, but to ensure a smooth install, we've created this pre-install checklist. As you can see, we're just looking for basic information, pictures of the press and the console, so that we can confirm that we can interface with the press. The document also contains the prerequisites for a successful install and our 30-day money-back guarantee. So basically, you know, we'll stand behind this product, we will install this product, we'll train you on this product, and we'll make sure that it's working the way you want it to work. If any time within those first 30 days the system is not working the way you'd like it to work, you can return it to us, pay for shipping, and you'd get a full refund of your money. So that about winds things up. Like we said, we wanted to keep things short and sweet for you guys today, just so we can show you, you know, the basic parts of the system and how it works. We're now going to open things up, open up the floor for any questions. So again, as Chelsea mentioned at the beginning, if you could use the control panel on the right side to submit any questions, and we will start answering them as they come in. All right, so we have a couple of questions. The someone was asking for the press check document. I'm assuming that's the pre-install checklist, and that is something that we could send along to you. So I'll make a note of that and send it along. We have a question about PressLink being used for sheet-fed or also that presses.
Yep.
And the answer would be yes, that it can work for both types of press. Let's see. How would you interface the SpectroDrive for closed loop? So basically, the way to think about it is the SpectroDrive isn't actually connected or interfacing with the press at all. The SpectroDrive is going to interface with the software package. And the software package is what's going to be connected to the press. So we have different interface cards. Again, it depends on the, you know, type of press, the year it was manufactured, the type of console it has on it. Sometimes we go in through a tape emulator. Sometimes we go through a job card, a floppy disk, or sometimes we can just use a direct press interface and interface directly with the console. So someone's asking here, sheet-fed offset printers of the system online or offline? Can it measure and adjust on the run? So it's not an actual inline system. You'd be pulling sheets during the run and scanning them with the SpectroDrive scanner, and then it would make those adjustments automatically for you from there. But it's not something that's going to be measuring while the press is running. The end user, the press operator, is actually going to decide when to take the scans. And change the end keys from there. We also have a question about gravure printing. We mentioned very quickly at the beginning of the session our Spectro Edge, which is an inline device that does measure inline, that is created specifically for the gravure printing. So that's something that, again, we can reach out to you and we can discuss that product offline. So can the SIP3 data be modified for coded versus uncoded by the operator and saved for future setup? Yeah, basically anything that you would normally set in that file from prepress, you're going to set it up the same way you would normally set it. But our converter is just going to convert that file so it's actually reading it as an ink presetting file and what those ink keys should be preset to as opposed to just seeing it as like an image file per se. And those can be saved for future setups. You can save reprints, so you can go back in and pull up a previous job, and that ink key information would be saved in there from the last time you did it. I also see a question for PressLink works with G7 and ISO. Those are both accurate. There is an option to control the press, you know, based on G7 standards, and you can base it off ISO as well. You could just base it off the LED readings. You could base it off density readings. It really depends on how you run your shop. There was a question about a difference between our system and digital information system, which is, I think, CMYK's closed-loop solution. They're very similar. Both solutions, you know, at the heart of things, get the same mission accomplished at the end of the day as far as setting ink keys. We like to think we have a little bit of an advantage as far as our price goes, our customer support goes, and again, the scanner that comes with it, the hardware that comes with it is going to be different. You know, we could talk a lot about the differences between the Tescon Spectro Drive and one of the, you know, let's say maybe the X-ray scanner, but that's not something I don't think we're going to really get too far into today. There's a question for using closed loop for web offset. You know, it is possible. The only thing being, like we said, on that back end in the you know, when you're in the color control software and you're taking scans of the color bar, it's a lot easier in sheet fed to pull a sheet off and scan that sheet. As you know, with the web, you're in a continual roll of paper. So we do have people using it, and what they do is they simply would walk up and, you know, cut a sheet off and scan it that way. So it is an option to use it for web. There's just, you know, an extra step and a little bit of work involved as far as keeping that web going. Can the jobs be saved as a customer, I think, as opposed to preset tolerances? Yes, you can save the jobs basically any way you want to save them, again, through reprints. So you can, you know, your tolerances, basically, you can leave in there and change them per job, and you can call up any job that's already saved or start a new job and run them under those tolerances. So basically, the two are independent of each other, however however you'd like to run. Can you make your standards custom? I think your tolerances and the numbers that you want to hit, that is accurate as well. We obviously know that out there, there's probably not going to be two printers in the world that have the same tolerances set for you know, all the measurements that they'd like to take. So yeah, you can definitely go in there and set those, you know, those deltas, those tolerances, wherever you'd like them. A couple other questions in here. Does the system work with UV inks? Again, as long as it's something that we can take measurements of, as long as we have that pre-press file to set the ink keys, this system, you know, will work. You know, it really doesn't matter what you're printing on, per se, as long as we can take that measurement, that's not an issue. We have a question about the ROI, what type of press it's based on. It's not really based on any type of press. The numbers that you need for the ROI are your make-ready time, your cost of paper, your cost of ink, how much of the hourly, how many jobs you're running, the hourly rate of the pressman, things like that. So it really doesn't matter what press you're running. It's more a return on investment based on how much work you're doing. We have a question about newspapers. Again, if possible, it's just more of a something that we need to know more about your actual system and how it's set up. It's not something that I can just say a flat out yes or no that it would work for a newspaper. Rotative offset printers, can the system be installed online? If you need inline measurements, you know, whether it's offset or flexogravure, doesn't really matter. We have our Spectro Edge, inline scanner that does have a spectral head on it that can be mounted to any press and take measurements inline. That does not really combine with the closed loop system, though. It's just going to display measurements and give you suggestions on moves that you can make to the ink keys on your own, as opposed to automatically making those changes for you. We have a question about setting up closed loop with PressLine software. Yes, we do know that works because we know our scanner does work with the PressLine software. We have experience with that in the past. Does the system work with all kinds and models of press? That's a great question. Again, not something I can just say it works with every model of press. You know, most presses out there we can work with. Heidelberg, Mitsubishi, Manrolin, Komori, KVA, Ryobi, I mean, you know, pretty much anything out there we have done already. And we basically take it on a case-by-case basis. So if you come to us and you tell us you have a Heidelberg press and everything's very standard, we usually know right away that we can hook up to it. If you come to us with, you know, some sort of press that we've never hooked up to before, we would ask that you fill out the pre-installed checklist, get us pictures of the press, pictures of the console opened up, and that way we can confirm whether or not we can hook up to it. So we're not going to, you know, give you quotes and go through demos and do any of that work without knowing that we can hook up to it first, because that would be, you know, quite honestly a waste of our time and a waste of your time. So we have a question here about using specific color bars or if they can be, you know, a custom bar. It does not matter what the color bar is, you know, how it's set up. It can basically be any color bar out there. And that's something that we would work with you guys on. We're out installing the system and training everyone on it. We'll work on getting your color bar set up the way that you want it set up in the system. We have a question about Pantone colors being adjusted with closed loop. That's also something that can definitely be done. So, you know, it's just a matter of loading that library and measuring against that library, the Pantone library, as your tolerances. We have another question here about exporting data to interface with a third-party color software. There are other ways you can export the data. I don't know if you'd want to do it through this software or through the TestCon software that comes with it. So you can definitely export the data. I think XML is definitely an option. I just can't, you know, say for certain that it would definitely, you know, interface with a third-party software. That's something that we'd have to do a little bit more research into. Looks like that's it for questions for now. We'll stay on here for a few more minutes just in case there's any other questions or anything that anyone needs to ask at this point. We definitely have a few minutes. We've had a couple questions come through about the checklist, so we'll make a note of the people that have asked for it on here. We have your email addresses, and we can email that to you directly. Give them just another minute. What is the size of the aperture of the instrument? Basically, the patch size that we are looking for on your end is a 3x3 patch. The aperture is 1.5 millimeters. A couple other questions about the details and getting a copy of the presentation. Again, that's something we have your email addresses here. So we recorded the session here today. So we'll send out a recording of the session probably at some point tomorrow to everyone as a follow-up. And we'll, when we send that out, maybe we can include the checklist and a couple of the ROI calculator, things like that, just so you guys have all the materials from the presentation. Okay. We have a question here, and this is something that actually I'm glad that you asked, Samuel, about the selling ink presetting alone. The system is modular, so you could have, if you have really, you know, short make readies currently, and that's not really something that you struggle with, you could potentially just add the SpectraDrive scanner and the color control software, or you could just have the ink presetting software if that's where, you know, your troubles lie. And then on the back end, you could just be taking measurements and making adjustments on your own. So you can have any of these pieces kind of independent of the other, or of each other, I should say. And yes, Sam, that's something that I'll email you after this, and that's a conversation that we can have offline. The costs do vary, again, depending on the press. We could use different interface cards that are different costs to us. So the cost usually varies anywhere between the high 50s to, you know, mid $60,000. We do have a question about supporting this product. We do. We always install when we set these up. We install something called TeamViewer, so we can always access the system and make any changes. We actually do go in and try to optimize things, as time goes and as you're getting used to using the system and using it more. So we don't have, you know, a representative really in India, but we could sell you the product and we could just support it remotely. We could have someone come out to do the install, that sort of thing. But as far as supporting it from there, it's usually not something that we have to come on site for. If there's an issue with the actual hardware, with the SpectraDrive, we do have a full loaner program. So that's something that, you know, you could send back to us to have repaired, and we'd send you out a loaner in the meantime to keep you up and running. We'll give it just another minute, because it seems like there are a couple other questions trickling in. A lot of them are just saying thank you. But please know, you're welcome. We got those messages. All right. Well, I think that about wraps things up. Looks like all the questions have come through at this point. Again, we appreciate your time today. We hope you guys were able to learn something about the system here. Any of the people that asked for anything specifically, we will get back to you offline. And as I just mentioned, we have recorded this, and we will send the recording out as well so you can share it with anyone who, you know, possibly wasn't able to make it. So, again, thank you all for your time, and take care. Have a great day.
Thanks, guys.